kind of our only option at this point.
What?
I mean, do you want
I
the full
of,
deal?
Yeah, let's do the deal. Let's do the full deal, yeah.
Yeah, it's all cool.
Grabbing my bow, and we're actually gonna shoot the new bow. So we're gonna run inside and see what that's all about.
And our little ballistic gel you got coming.
Oh yeah, dude.
That was just quick yesterday.
I'm excited.
It's crazy stuff, it's super heavy.
Isn't that
nuts?
Just hitting there.
Cups. Dude, I might come work
in that. 40-yard range over here, which is like the rest of the company has access to all the time.
Over there?
Yeah, but through this glass. Okay. So it's like the same as this. This is 50.
Is it on the wall?
All hanging up. So right here, this is V3, 31-inch axle-to-axle. It's the first pass parallel bow we've ever made. I think that's ever been made, actually. So the axles are pass parallel the whole time. It's actually the same riser length as a 31 and a half.
Yeah, it looks pretty similar to a 31 and a half riser.
With some new updates, we got center guard technology that we talked about a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
Cables cross perfectly in the center. So those cams are actually, there's still a top and a bottom cam.
Yeah.
But they're the same now. Each cam was slightly different before timing hole wise, mm-hmm. because there was different pressures on the cables, because the roller guard wasn't centered. So that's a huge deal in terms of consistency, and it makes sense, right? I mean, everything about it is like, well, why wouldn't those be the same?
Right.
I think it's something a lot of people don't think about, of they didn't realize that they weren't.
Right. Couple of that.
Yeah.
What's that? 70 something.
28, I'm not sure. But it also looks clean down here, like it all kind of hides.
Yeah. It feels good.
And then this is also a V3, and I'm not sure if we're calling it a V3 compact or if we're calling it what it is, but the number's gonna scare people a little bit, but I think it's unapologetically short.
Right, 27.
27.
Yeah.
So this is like, in my opinion, like the ultimate hunting rig. Like this thing sits in the front seat of your truck at all times.
Right.
It's in ground blind, like it's awesome. And so what it is, it's the same riser length as a VXR 28 at 27.
Right.
So limbs are past parallel again. Feels awesome. It's 4.25 pounds. So it's light. This one's actually quite a bit lighter than a 31.5 as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, okay.
This is 4.54, so it's 0.2 pound lighter. But all the same technology on them both. I mean, they're both V3s. It's just which V3 fits you, which V3 do you want?
Okay.
Yep, you can pull that. And so,
dude, that's small.
So the cams you'll see on the draw cycle are crazy close to these wings. I mean, at 75 pounds, they're just under 3/8 of an inch.
Really?
From the riser. But, I mean, everything about it, it's compact and just like a little killing machine.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. And we're not scared of that bow because you've got this bow. You know, right. Like if people are like, oh, that's too short, well, shoot the 31 because these are, I mean, these bows are equally as good.
Right.
It's just what hunting style fits you.
Right.
And so I feel pretty good about being able to fit a lot of people.
both of them.
It's pretty rad.
Yeah, I mean, it's short, but it's an awesome bow, and I think it'll shoot.
And then this one?
So this is the Prima, Prima. So that's the one as well.
Yeah.
That one's, well, I guess the cans aren't, but I think it's got the old Lemon graphics on there too, but but same, all updated technology, new cams. It'll be the same mods as the Avail was,
okay.
But the cams are updated. Same center guard technology. It's got the small 740 damper, dovetail on the back. We got AMO worked on some new limb legs this year, so the limb legs fit this as well. These are different than our normal engage. Those are,
yeah, so you have two different,
they're ones. Updated engage limb legs. I don't know what we're calling them.
I think it's engage compact.
It's under light. 4 pounds. Yeah. It's 3.96 or 3.9. I can't.
3.9.
That bow feels really good too. It goes to 27.5.
Yeah.
If you were 27.5 inch draw length, that bow is rocking.
It's fast.
Yeah, it's pound for pound the fastest bow we make.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Feels aggressive.
Yeah, I think those might be the speed mods on there, but yeah, you can shoot them all. Play with them all a little bit.
I don't want to shoot them.
I think
they each got their own quality.
Like, yeah. So this, in my opinion, I'm excited to run the vibration.
Mm-hmm.
This thing feels incredible.
Really?
And this is the best bow we've ever made. I think this being smaller and lighter, it just gives it a slightly different feel.
Mm-hmm.
And it feels really good. People are gonna be worried about the string angle, but I don't,
as always, yeah, and that's just kind of part of it,
but it's not very different from 28 really. I don't know, I think you're gonna like both of them. Like, I think you're gonna want both of them in your
let's
setup.
Let's shoot the small one then first.
Yeah.
That one. That, you love a thousand. It's, yeah, super comfortable. Like, people can, in the situation. That feels way different than 28. Feels way different.
That sounded quiet.
Yeah, it did. I want to say it's smoother. Is the draw cycle a little different?
It's comparable. Those cams are new. I mean, definitely. People have said that. It's hard because we look at it on an Instron machine and we watch the graph.
Right.
And that's how we consider draw cycle, but it seems like the feel is always a little different.
Is this? Dude, it's smooth. It's smoother. Like, for real.
Sitting that low. Justin just put that loop on today.
I don't know why it's reading like that, actually. And no face pressure.
Last Friday.
garage length is plays a big role.
Oh, I'll be way lower.
Those are famous last words.
Right? Top of the hill. Rock solid.
Keeps also pretty crooked. Worry about that.
What? Well, everyone, hope you enjoyed kind of a factory tour and the first look. Brand new V3 and 31 axle-axle and 27 axle-axle. Both very different bows. Both for different kind of people or different kind of shooting style. You know, for me, right off the bat, this is a whitetail killer. You know, it's super small, compact, ground behind tree stand. And this holds better than this, in my opinion, for my draw length and what I shoot. So this will probably definitely be like an out west bow or shooting around for fun. So definitely looking forward to trying them out. And today's launch day, even though we're filming this months ahead of time, so make sure to check them out on MatthewsInc.com. Make sure to check them out on Bow Builder, local dealers. Catch you guys next time.